Would you like to get absolutely full without overeating? Then keep watching. Vegetable salads, fruit salads, potato, pasta, and bean salads, main dish salads, side dish salads, appetizer salads, cold salads, hot salads, frozen salads, jello salads, luncheon salads, dinner salads, supper salads. The varieties are limitless. Salad meals are quick to prepare when time is limited. Salads can be a meal in one. Salads can be hearty or light. Salads are among the most nutritious foods you can eat. Salads furnish important nutrients and fiber and bring to the menu vitamins and minerals that may be lost in cooking. Today, we will explore a variety of fresh salads that vegetarians use to accompany meatless meals or to be an entire meal in themselves. Salads are truly cooking by the book, eating God's original diet of the herb of the field and the fruit of the tree. A raw vegetable or salad, largely of raw fruits or vegetables, should be served at almost every lunch and dinner throughout the entire year. Raw foods contribute fiber as well as vitamins and minerals, and they are particularly important sources of vitamin C. Raw fruits and vegetables help to cleanse our internal living machinery and to purify our blood. One nice blessing from eating generously of raw salads is that you get full before overeating of too many calories. It's nice to serve a salad as the first course. Larger amounts are eaten when persons are most hungry. Salads can satisfy the appetite sufficiently to decrease the danger of overeating. And remember a simple little rule: the more green or the more yellow a vegetable is, the more vitamin A. As leafy salad greens become warm, the destruction of vitamins occur. So purchase only fresh, crisp greens. Wash them quickly in cold water, dry, and store airtight in the refrigerator. Keeping produce chilled helps save the nutrients you paid for at the market. Variety is the spice of life. Leafy green salads. Many choices of salad greens are available most all the year round. Some people think only of lettuce when they think of salads. However, other salad greens can be used. Each has a distinct flavor, color, shape, and texture. A combination of greens can give a salad a pleasing, distinctive flavor. Escarole has a dark green leaf edged in yellow with a mild flavor. Curly endive adds dark green color, lacy texture, and tangy flavor. Fresh young spinach adds color, flavor, and nutrients to a salad. Iceberg lettuce has a compact head with tightly packed leaves and mild flavor. Bib lettuce has sweet, tender, deep green leaves. Romaine has long heads with crisp leaves and sharp nutty flavor. Leaf lettuce has a crisp, light green, curly leaf with a delicate flavor. Salad greens need to be washed and refrigerated to crisp the day before using. You simply separate the leaves from the leaf lettuce to wash. Be sure that you get a couple of washings so that the sand is all off. You change the water a second time. If the lettuce contains sand, wash it off. Discard the bruised leaves and shake out the excess water and blot them dry with a clean dish towel if needed, and store them covered in the refrigerator crisper or plastic bag in the refrigerator. For head lettuce, you can hold the head with both hands bottom side down and hit the bottom hard against the countertop or other flat surface, and this will loosen the core. And you can remove the core with your fingers, and you can run the cold water down into the hole so that the head is washed thoroughly. could shake out the excess water and let the lettuce drain on a towel with the whole side down. Store it in a large plastic bag or a covered container in the refrigerator. The leaves are ready to use as you need them. For salad pieces, you want to tear the leaves into bite-sized pieces. Do not cut them with a knife, as they bruise easily and the edges turn brown more quickly. Tender leaf lettuce varieties wilt down very quickly when salad dressing is added. Therefore, do not add salad dressing until just ready to serve or pass the dressing. If making salads ahead of time, store them covered in the refrigerator without the dressing added. This is a good time to mention healthful eating principle number 13, because raw salads need a lot of good chewing. Take time to chew your food thoroughly in order that the saliva may be properly mixed with the food and the digestive fluids called into action. Remember, you have no teeth in your stomach. Digestion of carbohydrates begins in the mouth. Let each bite linger in the mouth as you chew it thoroughly before swallowing. The digestive juices can't do their work properly if you swallow bites of food half-chewed or quickly wash them down with liquid. When I need an especially nice dinner salad for special occasions, I like to make tangerine walnut toss. Let's make it now. Tear 7 cups of romaine lettuce. We have the romaine here, the long-leafed romaine lettuce. Wash it thoroughly as we suggested and tear it into bite-sized pieces. And add 2 cups of tangerine sections that have been drained. 1/2 cup of diced celery. 1 tomato chopped. 1/3 cup of Italian dressing, which we're going to make for you in just a moment. And walnut croutons. Let me show you how we make the walnut croutons. We take a tablespoon of margarine in a saucepan and add 1/4 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 cup of walnuts. We just toss the walnuts until they're toasted and let them cool. Do this ahead of time and then combine all salad ingredients and toss it with the dressing just before serving. So you'll see this salad completed at the end with our low-calorie Italian dressing. We'll come back and add the croutons in just a moment. Remember to toss your tangerines and other ingredients in just before serving. There's an unusual sprout salad with avocado dressing that can be made quickly as an alternative to lettuce salads. You might remember to try it when lettuce seems especially high-priced in the supermarkets. You can produce your own sprouts at home for a few cents. The recipe calls for 2 cups of bean sprouts. These are the bean sprouts made from the mung beans, and you can find them in your market or in an Oriental store. 2 cups of sprouts. 1 cup of raw sliced mushrooms. 1/2 cup of raw, fresh, or frozen peas. 1 box of alfalfa sprouts. You can sprout these yourself. We have a little sprouting section in our cookbook, and it gives you the directions for making your very own sprouts at home. Pull them apart, toss this together. Toss it lightly. And and add 8 dates that have been pitted and chopped. The dates give a very interesting flavor, and you probably have never thought of trying sweet dates with a tossed salad, but we've gotten lots of compliments as we've served this with our avocado dressing. It's delicious. We'll have this ready to show you at the end of our lesson. We'll put it in our pretty salad bowl. And this will be served with our avocado dressing that we'll be making right now. To make the avocado dressing, we're going to use the blender. If you do not have a blender, you need to mash the avocado and mix things together with a wire whip. So in our blender, we'll place 1 cup of yogurt or buttermilk. We're using plain yogurt today. Low fat or non-fat. 1 medium ripe avocado. We have a large avocado, but I like to be generous on it. Let's just use another portion here of this large avocado. 1 medium lemon made into juice. 1/2 teaspoon of dill weed, 1/2 teaspoon thyme, and 1/2 teaspoon salt, and a dash of garlic salt. We'll whiz these up in our blender till they're smooth. And here we have our avocado dressing. All natural, with fresh avocado, lemon juice, and yogurt. Have you ever thought of shredding raw carrots, beets, and turnips for a fresh dinner salad? Quite delightful. I call it rosy crunch salad. Just take 1 cup of shredded raw carrots, and 1 cup of shredded raw beets. And 1 cup of shredded raw turnips. 1/4 cup sunflower seeds, raw or toasted. Toss all together. Toss together with Italian dressing and sunflower seeds and serve on a bed of endive or lettuce. We'll be making that Italian dressing in just a moment. Garnish with green pepper rings. Beautiful color means lots of minerals and vitamins. This Italian salad dressing contains no oil. The fruit pectin gives it the feel of oil without the oil. Using water and fruit pectin instead of oil in other salad dressing recipes works great too. Supermarkets carry fruit pectin with the fruit canning supplies. It's used to gel jams and jellies. If the dressing sets up too thick, add less fruit pectin the next time. Here's the recipe. Take 1/2 cup lemon juice, 1/2 cup water, 1 to 2 teaspoons Italian herb seasoning, start with 1 teaspoon, 1 teaspoon salt, 1/8 teaspoon garlic powder. Add 1.5 to 2 tablespoons of the fruit pectin. Sure gel or MCP work fine. 1 tablespoon sweetening, such as sugar or honey. 1/2 cup in the blender. Pour this into your salad bottle and chill it in the refrigerator. The fruit pectin thickens as it sits. The 100 calories per tablespoon that oil yields is completely absent in this delicious salad dressing. All right, now for lemon French dressing. You can do it in the blender or just using a wire whisk. We'll take 1/4 cup water, 1/4 cup olive oil, 1/4 cup lemon juice, 1/2 teaspoon paprika, 1/4 teaspoon salt, 1 tablespoon honey, 2 to 3 teaspoons of the fruit pectin powder to thicken. Add the garlic, or you can add garlic and onion powder, dill weed, sweet basil, celery salt, and so forth to season. You can shake it together or stir it with a wire whip. Here's our sure gel, 1 to 2 teaspoons of the sure gel. This will just give you the slightly thickish feel without any oil whatsoever. Reduces the calories greatly. If you would like a thicker French dressing, simply add a little condensed tomato soup, and that will give you a very thick body to the French dressing. And here we have our low-calorie French dressing. One other vegetable salad that requires no lettuce and holds well in the refrigerator to serve even if made the night before is marinated cauliflower salad. Mix together 1/3 cup vegetable oil, 2/3 cup lemon juice, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon oregano, 1/2 teaspoon sweet basil, 1/2 teaspoon garlic salt. Pour that over 1 large head of cauliflower that has been sliced. 1 6-ounce can of pitted ripe olives that have been sliced. And 1 medium green bell pepper chopped. Toss together. We'll put this into our serving bowl. Red radish slices are also beautiful added to this salad. And refrigerate and chill until ready to serve. Have you noticed that in my cooking I use lemon juice wherever a recipe calls for vinegar? Lemon juice is fresh from a tree, full of vitamin C, and pleasantly tart. Vinegar is naturally or artificially flavored acetic acid, commonly ranging between 4% and 6% acid. Mild gastritis may be caused by it, according to the Journal of the American Medical Association. In a study reported by the U.S. Department of Agriculture, Handbook No. 8, vitamin C losses were studied in individual cabbage salads containing vinegars. The losses in salads made with French dressing were lower than those containing the same amount of plain vinegar. Bronson, in Nutrition and Food Chemistry, declares that vinegar lengthens the time that vegetables remain in the stomach. Vinegar's acidity hinders digestion. You will find a number of salad dressing recipes in our recipe book. I prefer to make my own homemade salad dressing so that I can use lemon juice for the tartness. A simple dressing is to squeeze fresh lemon juice and a little olive oil over the salad greens, or just plain lemon juice without the oil. Try substituting lemon juice whenever a recipe calls for vinegar. You will be delightfully surprised. Now we have our walnut croutons all ready here to sprinkle over our tangerine walnut toss salad. You want to be sure they're cool, and then add them right before you serve. In commercially prepared salad dressings are found numerous spices. The natural food cook differentiates between spices that are irritating and safe herbs for food use. One condiment that I do not keep in the house is pepper, neither black, white, nor others. Pepper is known to irritate the gastrointestinal and genitourinary tract and cause blood pressure to go up. Other irritating spices include horseradish, cloves, allspice, cinnamon, mustard seed, ginger, nutmeg, curry powder, and chili powder. The list of safe herbs includes the following: basil, garlic, rosemary, bay leaf, marjoram, saffron, caraway, mint, sage, celery seed, onion, sesame seeds, coriander, oregano, spearmint, cardamom, paprika, the Spanish type, tarragon, chives, and parsley, thyme, dill seeds, peppermint, turmeric, fennel seed, poppy seeds, and wintergreen. And by the way, we should mention the use of salt in our salads, dressings, and all our cooking. Healthful eating principle number 14 says, be careful in your use of salt. Americans use 8 to 15 grams daily, but ideally should use no more than 5 grams. That's 1 teaspoon. Too much salt in the diet causes high blood pressure. In the United States, about 1 in 3 adults has high blood pressure. If these people restrict their salt and sodium, usually their blood pressure will fall. To reduce the use of salt and sodium, try these suggestions. Use salt sparingly, if at all, in cooking and at the table. Taste your food before you reach for the salt shaker. Most ready prepared foods, fast foods, prepared mixes, canned soups, frozen dinners, and salad dressings contain considerable amounts of sodium, as do pickles and condiments, soy sauce and olives, and ketchup and mustard. Use sparingly all salted snacks, chips, crackers, pretzels, and nuts. Read the labels when shopping. Anytime you see the word sodium by itself or in combination with another word, you have found a hidden source of sodium. An example is monosodium glutamate, MSG, or sodium citrate. Fast foods are often high in sodium. The desire for salt in foods is an acquired taste, which you can change. Buy more fresh, unprocessed foods. Look for low salt and no salt products. What an array of colors and textures we find in fresh salads. A number of years ago, a man in blue jeans visited our church. As he passed through town, he had no money to buy store-bought food to bring, but did not come empty-handed, having gleaned some of God's wild greens near the country youth hostel where he was camped. When he joined us for the after-church fellowship luncheon, he humbly placed a bowl of wild miner's lettuce salad on the buffet table with the following poem beside it. Miner's lettuce, washed by the dew created by God for me and for you. Nibble a little, save some for your friends. Some things God gives, and others He lends. But whether a gift or whether a loan, always send your thanks to the heavenly throne. What an impression that act of sharing what he had, however simple, made upon me. I've thought since of how much more often we would invite folk home for a meal if we didn't think we had to spend hours preparing a fancy dinner. I've learned that sharing is the important thing, not the fancy meal. I've learned that simplicity is God's way in life, not only in eating, but in faith. God promises in Matthew 6, 33 and 34, that if we set our mind on God's kingdom before everything else, all the rest will come to us as well. All our physical, mental, and spiritual needs will be supplied. He tells us not to be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will look after itself. What a God, what a promise. Dear God, I want to continue to not only cook by your book, but live my life honoring you. I pray for each one of our viewers. Give them good health and an appetite for lots of fruits and vegetables and salads. Amen.
Recipes shown in this program are available in Marcella Lynch's companion cookbook, Cooking by the Book. This 315-page cookbook is filled with healthful plant-based recipes and meal ideas that are delicious and easy to make. These low-fat, low-cholesterol dishes will help your family get a balanced diet that promotes better health. To order Cooking by the Book, call 1-800-655-9071. Or you may email to lynchmarcella@gmail.com.